Breaking down Lord of the Rings weapons for Alex's birthday. First off, Lord of the Rings does a really good job of integrating fantasy with reality with their weapons. The only things that are really ridiculous are wielded by super powerful beings. Starting off with Sting, it's an elven dagger, and it is a bit unorthodox to see a dagger that's just a mini version of a regular sword. However, you can see this sort of design in medieval knightly daggers that were popular between the mid and late medieval periods. There are some things that are just regular longswords like Anduril and Glamdring, and we could go into what Oakshot typology swords those are, but that just sounds kind of boring to me. Hadhafang is probably my favorite sword in the entire franchise, and it's pretty much just a stylized version of a Russian Shaska saber. It's a really cool design. King Theoden's sword is pretty much just an arming sword blade, but the hilt really reminds me of some older Celtic-style hilts. The hilt is two horses coming together, and that is symbolic of their culture. However, I think that the older Celtic vibes that it gives off is pretty symbolic of the older dude himself. Although pretty much every elf is older than him. Orcrist is a really interesting sword because it's relatively simple, however, it's obviously very well crafted. And it's essentially just a stylized falchion. Sam's sword looks a lot like a Greek Ziphos to me, and that sword size would be about right for a hobbit. I'm not a big fan of the Nazgul dagger because the hilt curves down into where your hand would be, and even though this is slight, that's still a pet peeve of mine. I'm also not a big fan of the Mirkwood double-bladed sword, because double-bladed swords just really limit anything that you could do with that sword. Now, you could make the statement that elves having really high reflexes could pull a Darth Maul and put them to use, however, they wouldn't be good in battle formations where you can't make use of that dynamic movement that you would need to use. Now, at first, Fili's sword threw me for a loop, however, upon further inspection, it looks like a heavily stylized saxe, and one that's been modified heavily for cutting power in particular. And the high elven swords are really similar to the Japanese nagamaki, which is pretty much a katana blade, but with an elongated handle.